Katrina, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
Katrina, what is it that a stylist does?
Staged homes helps people present their houses for sale. So it's grabbing the attention of their target market, helping them to make an emotional decision for them to fall in love with the property when they buy.
Katrina, what are some key tips that you could recommend in presenting your home for sale?
Look, there's two things I ask people selling to be mindful of when they're selling their property. And the first is to make their property feel effortless. And they do that by, first of all, cleaning it to within an inch of its life, detailing just like you do a car when you want to sell one of your vehicle. You detail every little square centimetre so it's spotless. And you also want to make sure that there's not a lot of clutter, that it's easy to take that mental picture and fall in love with the property. The second major thing you want people to be really mindful of is creating a wow factor at that first point of impression for each area. So for example, when you walk into the lounge room, not necessarily looking at the TV and an entertainment unit, which is quite boxy and blokey, but rather looking at gorgeous artwork and a gorgeous couch that's welcoming and just is more luxurious than say a square flat surface. So that point of impression that creates the wow factor makes the room feel large and inviting and helps buyers see what it's going to be like when they have their first function in the property. So in other words, engaging the emotion as opposed to the logic. It's not only the inside of the house you need to focus on, but it's actually what the buyer sees right up to the front door of the property. The first point of impression might be the neighbour's lawn. So if the neighbour's strip hasn't been mown for 3 weeks of a growing season, get out there and mow it, because that's often what buyers see first before they see your property. Often home hunters or people looking for their homes will drive past a house before they go and see it. So it's really a great idea to put all your lights on evening times at dusk, as people come and look at the house. And if your house is shining like a beacon, it's that much more exciting and inviting for people to come through and decide that yes, your house will be on the list to come and have a look over the weekend. I often say to people, put on your obsessive compulsive hat, because you just want every leaf picked up, you want a new doormat, you want everything detailed, even the numbers polished on the letterbox, just so that every point that a customer comes to or a home buyer comes to, they're feeling it's new and exciting and inviting. Then when you move inside, you want your entry to be just an introduction to what's coming to the rest of the house. Then you often come to a formal living room, if possible, media free, no TV, and all about lifestyle, inviting people over. Lighting is really important in these rooms, so even in the middle of the day, having that floor lamp on and the table lamp on adds that mid-room glow and ambience, which is beautiful and inviting. I often get a question as far as, do we dress a bedroom as a study, because we don't have a study? And my theory is that a bedroom is always worth more than a study, because technology these days, we can have a study anywhere. The trick to bathrooms is first of all taking away any personal products, because the worst thought is going into someone else's shower. You want a new feeling about it, and the way to do that is to clean it again, detail it to an inch of its life, but then bring in a newness about it. And the bathroom might be 50 years old, but if it's clean, you've got new towels, you've got some sort of fresh flower or plant and fresh soap inviting people in, no one else's toothbrush or hair products or soap, or it's all new and fresh and clean. Again, that's easier for buyers to imagine themselves there. Now kitchens, when you get to your kitchens, if you can, it's always great to have stools at the bench. It represents that other meals area. And to focus on one or two key or accent colours. And what happens if you have a bowl of all the one fruit, like green apples or red apples, and then accent it in another corner with the same colour, the eye naturally goes from accent point to accent point. It follows along the bench and it takes in all the attributes of that kitchen.
So when it comes to preparing a property for sale, what is it that you do?
So we offer a range of services that pretty much meets you and your property where you're at. For example, some people only need a consultation, and that is going through their house cupboard by cupboard, room by room, and just deciding what to put away, what to pack away, and what to keep. The second thing we do is fill in gaps for people, and we call that our mix and match package, where we, for example, bring in modern artwork or lamps or cushions or mirrors, sometimes linen, just to lift a room and tell it a different story. And then the last thing we do for people is if, say, they've moved overseas or it's been newly renovated, or for developers, we go in and deck the whole property out, and that's our complete stage.
Katrina, what is it that you love about what you do?
There's two reasons I absolutely love what I do, and the first one is having that creative outlet and being able to put together a house and turn it from a blank canvas into something beautiful and have it done in half a day is awesome, awesome job satisfaction. But more than that, way more than that, is just being able to help the ordinary mums and dads get that extra amount for their property. I've had clients that have come back to me once their property is sold and said that the mum hasn't had to go to work for the next year because they got that extra $40,000, which was her wage for the next year, which meant that the children didn't go into daycare and she just wanted that extra year. So that was awesome.
Katrina, thanks so much for being on the show. We really appreciate all your advice and insights on how to prepare your home for sale.
Thanks for having me.